And the next talk is Svetlana Pastukhova on resolvent approximations of elliptic differential operators with periodic coefficients under low regularity condition. Please.
First of all, I thank organizers for inviting me here to make the talk. My talking is not the first, which is devoted to homogenization. So the results which we will discuss now are in some consonance with those that were discussed by Tatiana Sanna Suslina. Consider divergent second order elliptic operator A epsilon with epsilon periodic coefficients. Epsilon is a small parameter tending to zero. So coefficients are highly oscillating, and this strongly non-homogeneous operator is the object for homogenization theory, which first of all finds the homogeneous operator with constant coefficients approximating initial operator A epsilon in some sense. We are interested now in approximation of resolvent of operator A epsilon in different operator norms with different accuracy with respect to the small parameter epsilon, and consider two cases when elliptic coefficient matrix A epsilon, which is measurable, satisfies conditions of coerciveness and boundedness. So the first condition means that we have uniformly elliptic operator, and in the second case we will relax the second condition. We allow coefficients to be unbounded in some extent, which we will specify later. But I start with the simpler case one and consider the simplest problem of homogenization. You see here the resolvent equation in the whole space RD with right side function F, with operator A epsilon, which is divergent type, second order, and coefficient matrix A epsilon is obtained by homotheta from one periodic matrix A of Y, which is assumed to be real valued, symmetric, and satisfying the two-sided inequality with some constant lambda, which we will call ellipticity constant. From long ago, it is known that the homogenized problem or limit problem will be the elliptic problem of the same class, but much simpler with constant coefficients, which can be calculated with the help of the solutions to auxiliary problems. Here are they. And relation below defines the homogenized matrix A0. From long ago, it is known that the solution of initial problem U epsilon converge in L2 to the solution of the homogenized problem for every function F from L2. And under additional regularity condition, it was obtained in 1970s the following estimate. You see here L2 norm for the difference of U epsilon and U, with majorant, which is the product which is the product of epsilon and constant C depending on Sobolev norm of function F and CM norm of coefficients, where the exponents k and m are sufficiently large. So in situation when we assume only measurability for coefficients and the right hand side function from L2, this estimate does not work. Not long ago, in zeros, it was much stronger result was proved. Here is L2 estimate for the difference of U epsilon and U with majorant, which is the product of L norm of F epsilon and constant C depending only dimension D and ellipticity constant lambda. This estimate in operator terms can be reformulated as the estimate one. You see here bound on the difference of two resolvents in L2 operator norm with majorant C depending on the dimension and ellipticity constant lambda and epsilon. This result was firstly proved by Biermann and Suslina. This was reported here already today. And I remind you that this result was proved by Biermann and Suslina by spectral method based on Bloch representation of the resolvent of differential operator with periodic coefficients. And a little bit later, Vasily Vasilyevich Zhikov proposed another method to prove such type estimate. This method can be called modified method of the first approximation with the usage of shifting. And briefly, it is often called simply shift method. According to the estimate one, you see that zeroth approximation for resolvent of A epsilon in L2 operator norm is the resolvent of the limit operator. We are interested in approximation of resolvent in other situation. First of all, in a strong operator norm, that is the norm from L2 to H1, called often energy operator norm, with the same accuracy of order epsilon. And we are interested also in approximation in the same operator norm from L2 to L2, but with accuracy of order epsilon and power two. In both cases, we must add to zeroth approximation resolvent of limit operator some correcting terms. And in the first case, in the operator energy norm, this corrector contain resolvent, gradient, and some vector multiplier consisting of solution to the cell problems. In terms of the solution of the problem one epsilon, we can reformulate this estimate two in the following form. H1 norm for the difference of U epsilon and so-called the first approximation is less than this product. Well, maybe I say that estimate two was firstly proved in our paper with Vasily Vasilyevich Zhikov. In case two, a corrector is more complicated. You should add also a joint operator K epsilon. K epsilon is the same as in the previous estimate. And if you and if we consider more general situations when operator A epsilon is not self-adjoint, matrix valued with complex coefficients, or we don't demand pure periodicity in coefficients and allow coefficients to be locally periodic or oscillating with different scales, then corrector will be more complicated. But in all situation when there is complexification of corrector, the operator K epsilon also becomes more complicated. You should include smoothing operator. For example, smoothing operator, Stiklov smoothing operator. I remind here is the definition. You see here, свертка. You see here convolution with kernel, which is a characteristic function of unit Q. You may use another type of smoothing operator with arbitrary smoothing kernel sufficiently regular in this situation. And estimate two becomes in such a form in general case. According to Zhikov approach, estimate four can be considered as the basic one among all operator time homogenization estimates for the operator A epsilon, because other estimates can be obtained from it as corollaries. Some of them are trivial and some are not so trivial. For example, if you weaken the operator norm, from this norm come to L2 operator norm, then you can consider correcting term as a remainder term and discard this term. And in the scalar case, you can show that smoothing can be omitted from corrector. Now we pass to the case with unbounded coefficients. Now we consider non-symmetric matrix and decompose it into symmetric and skew symmetric parts, AS and AC. And the first condition C1 will be uniform ellipticity for the symmetric part and skew symmetric part will have entries from the space BMO with BMO seminovice less than the same constant lambda in ellipticity condition for symmetric part. Then under condition C1, the problem one epsilon is uniquely solvable. All the attributes of homogenization make sense. And we can give here the following estimates five in operator energy norm from L2 to H1 and estimate in L2 operator norm with accuracy epsilon power two. Here we consider non self-adjoint problem. That is why I show you correcting operator, which is much more complicated than in estimate three. You see here K epsilon tilde, which is the counter of K epsilon for the adjoint operator to A epsilon. And also you see here operator L, which does not depend on the epsilon, but is defined as usual for correcting terms via solution to the cell problems. The result, the first estimate five was proved in our paper with Vasily Vasilyevich Zhikov, and later it was understood that our ideas can be extended and the second estimate 5 can be obtained. And now we consider condition C2, the same demand for the symmetric part, uniform ellipticity, and skew symmetric part has entries from the Lebesgue space LP over cell of periodicity Y, where P equal to D in dimension greater than 2 and P greater than 2 in 2 dimension. Under condition C2, problem 1 epsilon is solvable, but not uniquely. There exists at least an approximation solution to this problem. And I will a little bit later explain what it means, an approximation solution. And if we are discussing only solvability of the problem 1 epsilon, it is enough to require exponent P equal to 2 in condition 2. But for our goals of homogenization, we must increase the value of this exponent to D or even greater in 2 dimension. Now we will speak about approximation to the solution 0. But first of all, I comment what it means, approximation solution. We take the sequence of bounded skew symmetric. First of all, for simplicity, for the time being, let epsilon equal to 1, and the identity matrix will be the symmetric part of the matrix A. And at this moment, we take sequence of bounded skew symmetric matrix BN, converging in LP to the skew symmetric part B. And as the matrix, the coefficient matrix with Bn will be bounded, we can solve the solution 0. It is understood in weak sense. So the following integral identity holds, wherefrom we deduce the energy identity, and the corollary will be boundedness of the sequence of solution un in H1 norm. And extracting from un some subsequence convergent, we can pass to the limit in the integral identity star and come to the integral identity 2 stars, which show that limit function u is the approximation of the problem 1 epsilon of the equation 0. And it is interesting to note that the energy inequality for the solution u holds, not integral identity, but integral inequality. For equation under condition C2, maybe another type solution along with approximation ones exist, but we don't discuss them now. We will speak only homogenization of approximation solution, which surely exist in under this condition C2. And now I introduce the sequence of matrix BN approximating non-bounded skew symmetric part of initial matrix. So there are some ensembles of uniquely defined solutions U and epsilon with approximated matrix A epsilon N. The solutions of also of approximation type to the No. So there are all necessary attributes in this case in order to say that the estimate we were discussed earlier, estimates five can be proved in the case under condition C2. That's all. Thank you for your attention.
Let us thank the speaker. Questions, comments?
Евгеньевна, а кто там был не единственный? Какое решение задачи?
When we have a skew symmetric part B from LP, when P equal to D for dimension greater than 2, then the equation 0 will be solvable, but not uniquely. We can state about existence of approximation solution, for example. We can state about existence of variational type solutions. This is another type of solutions. There are solutions of such type equations, which are not approximation, which are not variational type. There is a theory of solvability of such type equation. But now in my talk, I discuss only approximation solution.
Other questions, comments? Yeah, I have one question. Your correcting terms, are they different or similar or just the same as?
They are rather Tatiana's similar in theory. All the cases we are discussing now. They are rather similar. But of course, in self-adjoint case, they are more simple. In non-self-adjoint case, they are more complicated.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, let us think again. And we have 3 minutes.
Раз. Включено. Так, и я презентацию утром скидывал. Да, я пользовался таким. Thank you.